Hey there, everybody. It's Maggie from Personal Euphoria with today's plank story. So we'll get right into it. Pick whatever move you enjoy and love and start moving. The clock is starting now. So I've been doing some additional research on breathing and breathing exercises, and I started reading this book, Breath, by James Nestor, and I know that'll be backwards for you. It's an easy read, quick read. I would recommend it. Some of the stuff in here is fascinating, and I double-checked it, and it's really sound research. Other things, I go, this seems like a pretty big leap to me, and I would continue to question it. But one of the pieces talks about there's this concept that that humans are not as good at breathers now, in part because our mouths have gotten smaller. And so there is a Dr. Mew who has a YouTube channel and talks you through exercises on how to use your own tongue to expand the size of your mouth and enhance breathing ultimately. So in the book, James Nestor describes these exercises as like using your tongue to hold back vomit, which doesn't sound appealing and might already turn you off from trying it. And I'm not saying you try it. This plank story is not to encourage you to try this exercise. But I went to YouTube and I watched some of Dr. Mew's videos. And as far as I can tell, he tries to describe that you're trying to, like, from here, pull your tongue up, suction it to the roof of your mouth. And while you're holding that suction, apply as much pressure upward as you can and forward, but not so much that you hit your own teeth. And so I'm experimenting with this exercise. You know, my type A personality is pushing that tongue on the roof of my mouth and suctioning as best I can. Then I realize, like, the roof of my mouth is sore, like feels raw. And I look in the bathroom mirror and I have given myself a hickey on the roof of my mouth. There are broken blood vessels and it was tender. The tenderness only, like by the night, it was gone. But the blood vessels have continued to slowly fade. And I had to laugh. I don't know if that's a sign that I am like the best at suctioning my tongue to the roof of my mouth. I don't know if that's normal or if it's a sign that I'm doing the exercise terribly wrong. But here is the thing. If you've ever wondered, could you give yourself a hickey on the roof of your mouth? You can give yourself a hickey on the roof of your mouth. Also, rest assured, this is not an exercise I would have incorporated in one of my Pilates classes ever, but if I ever am going to incorporate a new exercise, I'm going to try it first, because if there's a chance you're going to wind up with a hickey, I want to know before it happens to all my classes. Anyway, that is a 2-minute, 22-second plank. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. And as always, keep moving and have fun experimenting with exercise.